Okay, we showed you a couple of different methods. Now we're going to show you some of the unique products that are coming out on the market, different ways of setting those. This is what we're talking about. Some of these bigger piece panels that are being made, and how do we install those to the best to hold them up on the wall without any issue. So typically, instead of the mason way, you're not gonna sit there and back butter each one of these pieces. You're gonna trowel this out. So you're gonna use the tile method. A couple of things, you're gonna be able to gauge the material, get better coverage, and also speed up your process of installation. So we're gonna start in the same fashion. We're gonna go to the wall with some mud. And what we have in place right now is what we call a ledger. This is gonna support the work as we work up. When you go to the tile method and these big piece panels, you don't wanna try to freehand each one of those like the masonry installation method. So we're gonna trowel out an area. Typically you wanna trowel out what you can get covered with before it encapsulates over or dries up. That way you assure getting good transfer. So we're gonna start our layout, applying mud to the wall, making sure we get good transfer. Then what we're gonna do is apply more mud to the wall to trowel out for a piece of stone going up. Now, on bigger jobs, you might have two guys doing this at one time. You could have one prepping the stone, the other troweling out, and then one guy doing all the install of the stone. Today, I'm doing this all by myself, so I gotta try to do as much as I can, as fast as I can, without it encapsulating over. Remember, we always gotta worry about wind and temperatures outside. Those all play a factor. So once I get it troweled out and get some mud on the wall, then I'm gonna still do my grooves in the same fashion as I did the thin brick, trying to get that onto the wall. All right, once I get that laid out, if there's a little bit of cleanup on the ledger, do that before you set the stone. You just want to clean that off to where you keep it off the stone and not making a mess. All right, now we have the stone itself. We need to skim the back of that. So we're gonna take the trowel, a little bit of mud, and skim that out real quick. Then we're gonna take our stone and place it into the fresh mud, okay? Then we're gonna do in the same manner, we're gonna slide the stone left about an inch to inch and a half. With these bigger piece panels, you wanna maybe do that once or twice to collapse those ridges and get 100% coverage. So you're gonna press and slide and back into place. And you'll really feel it grab at that point. Press again and then back into place. A little bit of touch up or cleaning, just a wet sponge, wipe that off and clean it. Changing your water out every now and then. That'll ensure you get a good coverage and good adhesion of the stone. Once you get to this point, trowel out the next step, blending into what you already have up here, setting all the way down the wall, leaving joints, and then coming back and pointing. If you have any questions on the installation, reach out to our technical service department, our local distributors, and our local reps. They can all help you with the installation of these stones to make sure we're getting good coverage. Okay, once you got everything set and kind of cleaned up, after you get your stone set for the day, you want to let them set 24 hours before you come back and point, and also remove the ledger at that point as well. So if you got a multi-story building or what have you, you can keep working off of what you already set previous day. So with all that being said, this is a couple of techniques of getting the installation done right or done better. And please reach out to your local distributors, our technical service department, or our local reps for help in the future.